I love this camera. The Canon R6 for me has been a real pleasure to both shoot photos with and also to do filmmaking with. It's provided all of the features that I've needed personally, and I'm going to share with you today the top five features that I just probably couldn't live without if I was to upgrade at any point. Before we jump into these features, if you like photography and video and you like reviews and tutorials, hit subscribe and the notification bell. We'd love to have you on the channel. In-body image stabilization has made the Canon R6 a game changer for Canon, that is. Also, the Canon R5 has this as well. Before, I used to shoot with Canon cameras. There would be many times I'd be shooting with a lens and the camera. Both would not have image stabilization. This would make handheld work with video, with photography, really quite tricky. And a lot of times I would be shooting on a tripod or maybe even a gimbal. Fast forward to now, and we have the Canon R6, which has in-body image stabilization. It's really good. You also have access to the RF range of lenses and some of the EF range of lenses, which have image stabilization too. When you pair these together, you get a fantastic combination of image stabilization. It's brilliant for both handheld film, also handheld photography. Next up is autofocus. In particular, eye autofocus and how good it is in the R6. When shooting with the RP, I would find that the autofocus was very good. You could shoot a subject's eye at about 15 meters and get it in focus most times. With the R6, they took this to the dual pixel autofocus 2. This completely transformed it, in my opinion, and made it so much more sticky to the eye and so much more reliable at longer distances. You have different options here where you can shoot between people or you can then choose animals depending on what you're shooting, if it's portraits or wildlife. Now, I find both of these features to work exceptionally well when you're using the autofocus with the R6. And really, it's something that I definitely couldn't live without, because the autofocus on this camera has really gone to the next level, and probably it's the best autofocus system currently out there. Sometimes you need to capture the moment and you don't get a second chance. You kind of need a little bit of extra help from the camera. I find one of the best aids for this is high continuous shooting mode and a high fast shutter speed. For instance, if I'm shooting with the R6, I can shoot up to 12 frames per second mechanical or 20 frames per second electronic. That's huge. That means I'm always going to be able to capture the moments that I'm looking to capture, and I'm pretty much never going to miss them unless it's down to my own human error. That makes a big difference for me. This will also be a huge plus for wildlife, sports photographers, anyone that wants to capture that action at a fast pace. You know that you can put this camera into high continuous and get that burst speed that you'll definitely need. Canon have recently said that the R6 is one of the best performing low light cameras in the range, and I would actually say it's probably the best. Now, we're not talking about things like the cinema line, we're talking about obviously your handheld DSLRs or mirrorless cameras. The reason it's so good is because you can shoot down to -6.5, which is incredible. But don't just take my word for it, have a look at me actually doing this now. You can see the camera is able to lock on to pretty much a blackout. There is almost nothing that can be seen with my eye, and you're probably looking and thinking the same. But yet the R6 is able to pick out the object for focus and take a picture at these low light levels. Now, this can be really helpful in things like nightscapes, night photography, where you really need to actually shoot that way. Now, of course, you can use manual focus for this, and a lot of people will, but you also have that option with autofocus as well, if you need it. And it's just something that really takes the R6 to the next level and offers even better low light performance than you get with the R5. One of my favorite features of this camera is that it comes with 4K 60 frames per second. I've never had that option before, and for me it makes a huge amount of difference. The 4K on the R6 is incredible quality. At 24 frames per second, it's downsampled from 5.1K, which gives you even better quality. Now, I love being able to slow down my footage when I get it into Premiere Pro, because you add that cinematic vibe to your film and it just really makes your footage come alive. Now, having 4K alongside the C-Log setting, which this camera comes with, is even better, because you can then grade your footage when you're post-processing it as well. I do wonder if some of these features are as important to you guys as they have been since I got this camera. Let me know below what's been a game changer for you for the R6 or even the R5. I'd love to know what you guys have really kind of benefited from since you've got this camera. I want to thank you guys for watching the video today and joining along. And also, if you don't mind, give me a thumbs up. It really helps rank these videos higher and helps support the channel. Whatever you do for the rest of the day, guys, make sure it's a good one, and I'll see you in the next video.